everybody. My name is Carlos Laat and I'm a watchmaker here in the Netherlands. And today I would like to show you a bit more about the ultrasonic cleaning machine. I've seen some watchmakers using it not the right way. There are some misconceptions I would like to elaborate a bit more on, and I'm going to show you how to use it and an excellent trick how to test your ultrasonic bath if it's still functional and effective. And if you buy one second hand, you can test if it's still really working. So I think it's going to be a very nice trick. Shall we start? Cheers. Well, ultrasonic bath. I've been using this one for at least 8 years, day in, day out, just about every single day. I'm going to show you settings, some extra features this one has, and I'm going to show you what to use it for, because it's not a cleaning machine for watch parts. And if someone says, well, I've been using it for a cleaning watch part for 30 years, and well, that doesn't make it right. It's not a cleaning machine for watch parts. If you're into that, there will be a video on a cleaning machine and how to clean watch parts, because the ultrasonic bath is just for watch cases, case backs, and bracelets. We use the term bracelet if it's metal and a strap if it's leather. I'm not sure if it's right, but that's how we call it here in Holland. So just the real sturdy metal parts, we put it in a cleaning machine. When you're thinking about buying one, there are a few things you really have to think about. Size. Well, we're watchmakers, we don't use a huge machine. For instance, for clockmakers, there are huge ultrasonic baths. And they put in the watch parts, or the movement parts for huge clocks. And maybe that's why there's some misconception. Watch parts, especially modern ones, are way too delicate. And if I'm going to show you the test trick for ultrasonic bath, you will see yourself, you don't want to put all the delicate metal parts in there. It's way too aggressive. Second thing, the fluid we are going to use is water-based. It's just water with some cleaning agents. We're an independent YouTube channel, so I'm not going to give you any names. But if you Google just a cleaning agent for ultrasonic bath, you definitely find some. I know some fair amount of watchmakers who you just use water, tap water, with just a tiny bit of washing up liquid and methylated spirits, spiritus here in the Netherlands. It's the alcohol-based liquid you use to clean windows and stuff. I think it's called methylated spirits. You can use that. You need to degrease, and yeah, so you can do it yourself. It doesn't have to cost a lot of money. The cleaning machine, because it's water-based, is all used, just like always, with a simple dryer. Switch, hot air, cold air. Don't spend too much money on this. It's just blowing air through a heat spiral. So yeah, just use a simple one. This one, I'm going to show you the inside, because that is kind of special. And I'm going to show you the settings, because this one is a tiny bit different than the other ones. This is the inside of the ultrasonic bath, and you see there are some marks there. All the stuff you put in here is dirty, otherwise it shouldn't be in there. And some particles, some sand, whatever, is vibrating in the bottom of the machine. That's why you have to remove the liquid very regularly, because all the stuff here in the bottom is eating away at the bottom. Ultrasonic bath is simply, there are vibrating elements underneath this metal bath container, and it's vibrating, and because of the vibration it gives a horrible sound. And it's vibrating through the liquid, and that makes it all come loose and makes it really, really clean. So, excellent machine for the real heavy case, bracelet, stuff like that. Well, we can put in tap water. There's always a mark or an edge inside the container. You have to fill it up to there, because of the vibrating elements are most effective if the bath is full. This one is heated, but you can use a simpler machine and just put in warm water, why not? Here are some cleaning agents, and you can put in. And usually it's a ratio 1 to 20, so you don't need too much. But now, the whole bath is vibrating. So you really don't want to put your stuff you want to clean on the bottom. So there's always, or usually, a plastic container in here, and that's where you put on your the stuff you want to clean. I've been using this for a very, very long time, and you see it's even cracked. But no problem whatsoever. Just don't feel the need to buy another one. And then, if you switch it on, this one is, well, the one I prefer, but whenever you think is best, yeah, try to find that one. This one simply is the amount of time it will run. Way up there is infinite, and there is only 1 minute. This is the temperature, and the flickering one is the actual temperature, and that one is the temperature you want to set it. I usually do 40, 45 degrees. You don't need it to be extremely hot. It's nice if the liquid is warm, or the water is warm, because usually in watchmaking, the case and the bracelet, the wrist cheese is there. It's all fat-based, fatty and greasy. So you want to a bit warm, not way too hot, and that will dissolve all the fats and stuff. This one has sweep, and that means there are more vibrating elements in unison, and makes it a bit more effective. If you, it's not necessary. I like it a lot, but we use it all day, every day. Not really necessary. Well, What parts in there? If I start the machine, probably we will mute the sound because it's a horrible sound. The vibrating, ultrasonic. Well, there we go. Now it's vibrating. And you can see the stuff coming up. Well, horrible sound again. You can see all the contamination coming out of like clouds. It's just dissolving in the warm liquid and it makes it very clean. But because it's always vibrating, you don't want to have it on the bottom of your, on the metal container. So you want some plastic in it so it doesn't scratch. And you don't want metal to rub against each other. So this one is double folded, not the best idea. But we have to polish this bracelet anyway, so now it's no problem whatsoever. There may be some times that, especially with pocket watches and extremely old oil and lubrication and horrible stuff, and people try to do it themselves. Sometimes you just want an extra intense clean. Well, this is water-based, so I wouldn't use it. But there is a nice trick you can use, simply with a jar from, a jam jar or whatever. And if you put in you can use, this is wasbenzine. I think it's called lighter fluid in America, or naphtha. Or you can use isopropyl or alcohol, stuff like that, just to give it a good clean. And a nice trick. If you place that in the machine, look at that. The vibrations will go through the glass, will continue in whatever is in the jam jar. So you can have a good clean, really intense and not water-based, without contaminating your whole bath. So if it's really dirty and oily and horrible, just use it like that. Your bath will stay cleaner. And you can use the liquid in there, and the vibrations will go through the glass into this liquid. Well, if you buy a second-hand machine, you're not sure how old it is, how often it's been used, are the vibrating elements still in good condition. Even if it gives a horrible sound, doesn't mean the vibrations are effective, so effective in cleaning your parts. And there is a cool trick. And once you've seen it, I think you will agree that the ultrasonic bath is not the place for delicate movement parts for watches. Here is some aluminium foil, tin foil. It's the wrapper of Dutch peppermint. I think you can use the tin foil paper around a chocolate bar or chewing gum, stuff like that. Really, really thin, the thinnest you can find. Tin foil, aluminium foil, I'm not sure what your expression is, but you know what I mean. And we're probably going to mute the sound, but I'm not going to fast forward the motion. This is real time. It's going well, not really fast, but you will see. You definitely don't want to put your movement parts in here. And this is an excellent test if you buy a second-hand ultrasonic bath, if the vibrating elements are still in good condition. There we go. We see the holes appearing. Because of the vibrations, the metal is going to be fatigued. You see, it's just about completely gone. This is not the environment for delicate watch parts. I think you will agree. Well, I hope this information was useful. Ultrasonic bath, you use it every day, not on watch parts. You can use it water-based liquid, you can mix it yourself. If you want a good clean of heavy parts or whatever, use a jam jar, place it in, and the vibrations will go through the glass, through the liquid, and get a really intense clean. Excellent stuff. A good tip. If you got stone settings in a watch, diamonds or whatever, even the jewels in watch parts, which you don't put in there, they come loose. It's really vibrating, so it just comes off. And be very careful with plastic crystals, plexiglass. Because of the vibrations, plexiglass will get the tiniest cracks over time. So just please don't. It's not designed for that. Yeah, it's too powerful. So again, I hope it's useful. Hope to see you again. My name is Kalle Slaap and it's the YouTube channel ChronoGlide. I really enjoy making these clips and I really enjoy reading your comments. So please leave your comments what you think about it. And maybe future topics or projects. Hope to see you soon. See ya. Bye-bye.